So before I start, there are some people are saying they're having issues with submitting of assignments. I think you are very clear, and I'll start by just sharing about that. To submit your assignment, which is very, very simple and straightforward, is to ensure that still I need. So for the assignment submission, there are two options. So let me just write something here. So there's option one. Okay, now I'm just trying to get my hand on this. Okay, it's not working as expected. So let me do something. Let me just do one thing. Allow me to set up something here. Allow me to just do a certain thing here. Let me just to stop sharing. Okay. Need to stop. Okay, let me just come back to this. What is our meeting ID? For those who are saying they can't hear me, I knew I had muted myself because someone was in the room. Okay. So I think now you can see the whiteboard clearly, much better. So I think there are two options. There are two options to submit the assignment. That is assignment submission. Assignment submission. So the first option, and I think this is only one time that I'm going to show these. For those who are late into the class, they're not going to need. I'm going to drag others back because of this. So the thing for each one is when you're using the e-learning portal. Yeah, and let me start with the mobile app. E-learning mobile app. So this app is very clear, it's very easy to access. And if you haven't downloaded the app, just go to the website. I think I've sent this link to a number of people, so you can access through the app. Hope you can hear me now. So this is the first option. The second option that is there is when you're using the e-learning, using the e-learning portal. Here, you just go to the website, and that is the website. Here you go to the website. And for those who are saying they can't hear me, I hope I'm audible. I hope I'm very audible. I know I'm audible. So you just check on your audio and confirm. You can hear me? You can say yes on the chat if you can hear me. Thanks. Aaron, Kibuika, Teach, Minamu, Eroni, Neni, Kalia, Cherono, Phyllis, Naomi, thank you. So the second option that is there is when you're facing the portal. So the other option for the portal is e-learning. Your Taraka. That is the other option. Those are the two options that are there. So for these options, here you only use the laptop or the desktop. For this one, you use the mobile app. That is the Android. The mobile that is Android smartphone. So using the smartphone, you use that. That, I hope that is clear. That is very clear. So the details of why we do this, you can just ask those who have been able to submit. I'm not going to get into the details of that. So I think last week, we just reviewed the architecture of a computer. Those are coming in late. I think, what time? 3:40 I'll not be admitting people. You tell them to come to class early next time. I'll not be admitting people up until 5. So yeah. So we did the architecture. So when we talk about the architecture of a computer, it's very clear where we are going to be doing something like this. So we just draw something here. So we talked of different parts. I'll try my best to. Yes, clear. So you talked of different parts. Okay, so I've finished drawing something here, but you're going to be helping me to fill it up. So, Rose, you can just check. I hope I'm clear. I'm very clear on what I know. I'm very clear because I can confirm. I can see my audio how it is reacting, so I know I'm clear. So so you can tell me what is this part, what is here. You can just unmute and speak so that you move faster. What is there? Thank you, Archimedes. Yes, Faith, it is input divider. So this part, I will just color that is here. So this one is input device. What is here? Okay, what is here? What is there? Okay, I'm not unmuted. Let me just unmute, ask you to unmute. Let me give you the permissions to be able to unmute so that you can just say it aloud. Let me just do that shortly. I don't unmute if you're not speaking. So for those who can just unmute, somebody to just say it verbally.
Output device.
Yes, output device, thanks.
Output.
So it is output, right? And what about, right? Yeah. And once you
remember,
output, input.
Yes, that is. I'm hearing different answers. We also check
primary memory.
Primary memory, right? Yeah, so primary memory. Yourself. What about this one?
Secondary memory.
Secondary memory.
Yes.
Secondary memory. Okay. What about this whole part?
This team unit.
What do you call it? Yes?
CPU.
CPU.
Central processing unit.
Central processing unit.
So this is the CPU, and within it there are three main parts, which are those. You can start with the first one at the top, at the very top. Rainy.
Control unit.
Control unit.
I retry. So basically, this is what we now call the architecture of a computer. As part of your assignment, you are supposed to now explain each of them. So I will not explain it for the purpose of those who are submitting the assignment. So you must check on it, check on the purpose of it and expecting to know this. Then really, what does this part do? Okay, there's one part of what is that part?
The user, the operator.
Yes?
User or operator.
Yes, the user, right? So, the user, right? So, this is the user. And the user is a very important part. I think we talked about different parts, and we said the hardware, the software.
Software.
It's what?
Liveware.
Later on, you're going to hear this about firmware and other kinds of spyware and all that. But these are the most important ones. So once we have that in our systems and you understood that fully, the other thing is looking at is the physical appearance of a computer. So when we go to another page, Can you check that you are muted if you're not speaking? If you're not speaking, remain muted. If you're not doing that, I'll remove you from the class because it shows that you're not serious with the class. So that you go and do the other things that you're doing. Okay, so I'll just do this. Hello. Let it load. Taking some time. This feature looks bad. Is that is not muted. Stay muted, stay muted. They don't want to be policing people. Let us join. Okay. Yeah. We mute Rose Mwende. Don't know what she's being unmuted. Okay. I think we're good. Now we have that. So we just look around here. Looks good. Let's get here. So we have that. So once we have it here, so think of this as a physical appearance of a computer. And somebody says, beard science. Okay, you just look for your group. Alpha and men, just look for a group. I'm teaching beard dance. Okay. So this is the physical appearance. So I was expecting you can either draw or you can get a screenshot that you just add the labels. But that is what I'm expecting. So there's a name for this part. The name for this part, the name for that part, the name for that part. So you can tell me that is A, B, C, D. So you type on the chat, What is A? You just say what is B, what is C. You can just choose either. A, you say something. Okay, let's start with A. What is A? I know I'm going to get varied answers. You type, just type. Don't tell, don't unmute, don't speak. As people are saying CPU, someone is saying speakers, computer case, CPU, system unit, CPU. I'm seeing, okay. I'm saying, let's do A. Let's do A alone first. CPU. CPU, same CPU. CPU is okay. So I can say 98% of us are wrong. 98% of us are wrong. I'm seeing processor, even seeing keyboard. So what is A? Nancy, you can tell the others. There's only one person who was correct, was Nancy. Nancy, I think maybe you got up there. You can unmute and just say say the answer. I'm seeing also Daniel. Yes.
System unit.
Thanks. So the answer is that this part is what we call, okay, sorry, that's small. This part is what we call the system unit. For those who are saying CPU, those who are saying processor, for those who are saying keyboard, what else did I see? And all that, all these are not correct. For those who are also saying computer case, computer keys. That is also wrong. Somebody can confirm. Why is it not CPU? Most of us usually say CPU. Why is it not CPU? And if you got, if you wrote that in the assignment, that is all correct. Why is it not CPU? Why is it not processor? Why is it not keyboard? Why is it not computer case? It is not even floppy drive. Somebody can answer. Verbal, you can just unmute and speak. Why is it not CPU? For those who are saying system unit, why is it not CPU? And for those who are saying CPU, why is it CPU?
It's because.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yes, Al, who was speaking? Is it Juma? Or who was speaking? Somebody can say the answer. You can just unmute. I hope you have the ability. I think you can unmute.
Yes.
Yes, Brenda.
I said CPU because it's the brain of the computer and it's the one that processes information, as in data into information.
Okay. But yes, I know there's what there's no what you call the CPU, but is this the physical appearance of the CPU? Okay, let me just do this first. Is this the physical appearance of a CPU, Brenda?
No, but it's intact.
It is inside.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. For example, if I say somebody tell me who this is, and I give a picture of you, then will I say Brenda McKenna, or will I say intestines?
The big.
You'll say Brenda because you're not in the intestines. But what is the main component in the system unit?
Exactly. Even you have a brain, but we don't call you brain. We don't call you Brenda's brain. We call you Brenda because there's more to you than just your brain, right? There's your head. There's your heart. Yes.
But is CPU the main component in system unit?
Okay, it is. You can say that this is one of the main components, but it is not the only component that is main, right? So, for example, the brain is a main component in the human body, but is it the only main component?
No.
We have the heart, right? We have the nervous system. We have a lot of things that make us.
We can't hear you.
Yeah, there is something like scratches. Kindly shake your.
Yes, pardon?
Your audio.
Oh, my audio had an issue. Maybe it's a network issue. Yes. Maybe somebody tried to call me. I was not checking my phone on the other side. Maybe somebody tried to call me. Yeah, I guess that was the issue. I've seen there's a missed call somewhere. I don't know why people call me in class. Okay, so there we are. Let me just get my charger on this other side. That's better. Hope you've gotten the point, Brenda, right?
Yes.
Yes. So this is a system unit, is a system unit and not the CPU, because it does more than that, other than just that. So what is B? What is B? What is in B? What is in B? Yes, I'm checking the chat. Don't say it verbally. I'm just to see the answers. Thing, monitor. Somebody give me another answer apart from monitor. It is not the only thing. It's not the only answer that there is. There's another answer. Yes, I'm seeing screen somehow. Yes, screen things there. There's also another answer. It's not window. Okay, I know there's a window inside here, but that is not, it's not motherboard. Okay, this the two answers that are correct so far is monitor and screen. Okay, sorry, somebody was calling me. So kindly, I think let me allow people to first get in their audio first. If I start teaching and you just decide to leave the class, don't think you leave the class and I'm here to just allow you in or something of that sort. I know I can add somebody as the goals to be adding people, but I'd like us to have one class. The same way in a physical class, or is it called in here? That way, as in Nengeo Kitoka Kilasa. So, and if you're having issues with hearing me, just check your network. Check your network. Sometimes it might not be me. Confirm that you are in a good network so that you can hear me well. Okay, that's a good question, Diana.
Oh, ni kweli. Kama ni kelele za kwangu zinafanya nisikie. Mwalimu sikusikii kabisa. Ni kweli.
Okay. I think I'll put her in the waiting room. I have a kidogo. Sawa. So there we are. So just give me 1 minute, something to be sorted out here. Okay, I'm back. So I know some of you have already Googled and seen flat panel display, but the answer is very simple for those who are looking for the answer. So the answer is that display unit, because when you talk about, okay, there's also video which you can see, and you have video. Display unit can have that. So what is C? C is very clear. C? What is C?
Excuse me, teacher.
Yes. Yes, now.
I've said the answer for B is visual display unit.
Yes.
Why not monitor or screen?
I've said it, okay, monitor is allowed, but let's say if I connect this desktop to a projector, will that be called monitor? If I connect it to a TV screen that is a smart TV, will it still be called monitor? Yes, it can be called that, because the work of the monitor is to just look at what is within happening within the CPU, I mean within the system unit. But the most general answer is visual display unit. The same way we call ourselves human beings. We don't say, what is that creature? Then we say, Naomi. No, we say, that is a human being. If you look at a lion somewhere in the wilderness, you don't call it, hey, I've seen Simba called Tom or something. You call it that. So let me admit those two. So yes, I've seen the answer, which is very clear. No.
Yeah, clear.
Yes, you've gotten it. Hello, yes? Okay. So mouse, and what is the last one? On the chat, also again on the chat. The last one is on B. It is a question about pointing device. Okay, we can call it a pointing device, but it does more than pointing. It can be a pointing device, but it does more than pointing. So, because even a laser pointer is a pointing device, you see that. So, yes. The answer is unanimous, means that it's a keyboard. Thank you. So, now that we have that very clearly, let me see whether we can log in really fast. Let me log into the platform so that we check on today's is there any question so far with regards to the physical appearance and the architecture and the hardware? There are many other hardware. There's the printers, there's the projectors, there's the watch, there's the scanner, and all those. But still, I'm just going to give you a brief overview of them. Then you're going to see what goes on. So let me just take you back somewhere. Here's my whiteboard. Okay. Do another page. Blank page. Let me just do a simple search. It's a system unit known as the base unit. Okay, base unit, that is not a conventional name that is known along very widely. So I can tell you no. Let it just be system unit. Is the main memory a combination of primary and secondary? No. Main memory is just another name for primary memory. Main memory is primary memory. We said main memory is volatile. Who can tell us what is? Okay, let me, I've seen a very good picture here. Let me just get this here. I show you just something. Can you see printer, microphones, floppy disk are part of the physical appearance of a computer? If you have drawn it and it is there, yes, it is really part of the physical appearance. You can see like the one that I've just shown you. It has a speaker there, it has a microphone, it has that. Is a screen can also be identified as an input device? No, a screen is an output device. Is there a difference between a pointing device and a keyboard? Yes, a pointing device has a pointer. It always controls what we call a pointer. For example, if I show my mouse, you know how a mouse looks like, a mouse pointer. It, like a mouse can be called a pointing device because you can point with it. With a keyboard, you can't point on anything. So we are here. So you can see what we just covered. We looked at the mouse, which is very clear, the keyboard. You can see there's something that I've been added here. We have the speakers on either side, and also we have what you just said. That is why we call it the system unit and not the CPU. So you can see the whole part, this whole part. Let me just wrap this if you're not seeing it very well. This whole part. That is including the hard, you know, back then it used to be called a CRT, because although these days you don't use CRT. So at the front here is where we have the screen at the front, but the whole device is called the monitor. So someone asking, can a microphone is an output? That's now starting to ask me assignment questions. Microphone, is it an output? Somebody can tell us, is microphone an output or an input device?
Input.
It is input, right? Yeah, it is an input device. Can a barcode reader be identified as an input device? That is obviously because it is reading. So it is getting data from outside into the computer. So it is an input device. What are the functional differences between main memory and RAM? Main memory and RAM are almost one, because RAM is one part of what you call the primary memory. Primary memory has two things. It has the RAM and the ROM. So you just check that. You should check. So primary memory is what you call the RAM, which is random access memory, and is also what you call the ROM. And all of these can be identified as what you call main memory. Yeah, so it can all be called main memory. Have you gotten that? Yes. Is there any question? Continue asking. I'll be very willing to get that clear. So, okay. I'd like us to go to the notes so that we check on something on the notes that we have on the portal. We just get something clear. So, okay. So let us go back to the notes on the e-learning portal. so that we see something. Okay, let it load. So far, so good. I hope you are now up to date. That was a good recap. I always find it very important for us to recap on what we've looked at so that we see. So if I put my cursor the same time here. You know how much of it is showing. Let me just stop my share. Then I'll reshare so that I enter the password. Go back to Zoom. So let me enter my password first. For security, let me just stop the share. Okay, I'm back. Now we will go back to Zoom. Share. Okay. I am back. Now, let's look at what we might have not covered here. Let me see what we not covered there. So you can see at the end of this, we need to have already looked at. We should be able to know about the evolution of computing technology and the technological advancements. And the current technologies in the architecture of a computer. There's a question that was asked by Diana. We can see the system unit of a desktop computer, but we cannot see the system unit of a laptop. That is very clear. It's because for a desktop, we can physically see it because we can see the different parts. We have that, we have the keyboard, and we have the mouse. So that is why you can see the system unit, because it is separate from the desktop. I mean from the computer and the desktop. So, but when looking at the laptop physically, like that, just getting an idea of how a laptop looks like, it might not be as thick. Don't worry about my drawing. We can get to understand what it means. So when you're looking at the laptop, okay, you have the keyboard here on the top, but under the keyboard, on this part, let's say on this part here, there, just under, we just even draw this part, and there, in all that under view, and call it under. Under the keyboard. That is why we have the motherboard and we have the central processing unit. We have the RAM. We have the internal hard disk and many other devices that have been compressed or maybe made as small as possible and put under the keyboard so that you can be able to, it can be portable so that you don't have to carry different parts. So basically that is that. So I'll go back to the notes. So I know they're a bit small, but I'm just trying to see what we need to cover. So characteristics of computers, we already looked at that. And the other thing that we had needed to have looked at is the different types of computers based on size, price, and capabilities. I think that is what we need to look at here, and the fundamental difference between computer hardware and software. So let me go down here. So I believe you've already gotten these notes and you have them. Let me just here I can make it. So they can make it readable. Let me scroll here. Is it a bit better when it looks like that? I think it might look better that way. So when I go back here, so there are different types of computers and they are actually categorized according to the different types. You can categorize in terms of the size, categorize in terms of price and in terms of the capabilities or maybe what it can do. So the most prominent differentiation of the types is the size, of the computer. And you can see down here, all these are around these types is, can say types of classifications, but the classifications of computers. So when I talk about the classifications, it is according to size. Basically according to size all down here. So you can write this somewhere if you have somewhere to write. I would like you to go and check, although this one is all good, I'm not going to assignment it. I'd like you to check on the classification of computers. Like you to look at purpose of the computer, and then functionality. So the size, purpose, and functionality. But since you're looking at size now, I'd like you to check on the classification of computers according to purpose, and you tell me which they are, and then the functionality, and tell me which they are. You can do that. You can do that in the next class. So going on. So the first type, this is according to size. You're going to see you are moving from the largest to the smallest. So the largest type of computer we have currently is what you call a supercomputer. So they are really large, as you can see here, and they're usually the most expensive. And the reason why they're really large is they're actually able to do great, great functions. That is, they're able to process trillions of instructions in seconds. Also they cannot be used as a personal computer or maybe by a student in college. The government, they are used basically by governments and big large corporations. They are used for calculations and heavy work. And then there is they also used in industries, design products, and also it can be used in a very important thing, which is weather forecasting. Weather forecasting, it is also used for weather forecasting, which is a very good thing. Such a system, the task is broken down among processes for fast execution that are used for complex tasks requiring computational power. Okay, discard that. So I hope you've understood the supercomputer. At one point in time, you can check how a supercomputer looks like. So mainframe is another big computer, but it is not as large as a supercomputer. It can process millions. The other one is saying it was trillions. You can see here it is trillions. There you can see the trillions. But you can see here for mainframe, you can see basically, can say they don't understand the difference between functionality and purpose. So functionality, okay, you just search. That is what I'm asking you to search. Okay, so we go on. So same, it is less, not as large as supercomputer. And then they are used basically, you can see in hospitals. In hospitals, airline reservations, they can also be used in huge companies, because they have the capability of retrieving data in a huge basis. And also they can be linked to smaller computers and handle hundreds of users. And also something else it is used in space exploitation. I think it's space exploration, not exploitation. You can't exploit space, you can only explore. So the term mainframe is mainly used for the earliest computers. They are big in size. Today the term is also used to refer to large computers. A large number of peripherals can refer to them. And they are also quite expensive to install. Very expensive to install. So that is the mainframe computer, which is the second largest. The other one is mini computers. Very important to note that mini doesn't mean small. You know, sometimes you say mini, then when you talk about micro, for those who are doing business, they start saying there's micro computers and macro computers. There's nothing like macro computers. So going on to mini computers, they are smaller than mainframe, but they are usually bigger than micro computers. It should be bigger than micro computers. So they support concurrent users. They can be used as servers in companies. They are slower and less costly compared to mainframe, but more powerful, reliable, and expensive than the micro. So you'll realize that they have some uses. So it is just important when you're looking at it, don't just say that this one is bigger than this one, but less smaller than that one. Always look at what can they do. The example, you've seen that, I'll meet some people here. Okay, you've seen that mainframe can be used in space exploration. I've seen that, the supercomputer can be used in weather forecasting. Mini computers can be used as servers in companies. Then microcomputers, they're of advanced technology and used in large scale integration. We talked about large scale integration. And microcomputers basically encompass all those. Although sometimes we usually break down microcomputers and say, there is the desktop, then you go down to laptop, then you go to palm top, then you go to the smartphone. But they all are part of what you call the microcomputers, because they are all using the technology which you call the microchip. The microchip or the very large scale integration, all of that is micro, meaning very, very small. You can see down here, it's now broken down. Notebook is lightweight. Notebook, they are used Bulky. You can think of notebook and laptop are usually terms that are used interchangeably. So don't worry when you hear about notebook and laptop. Although you can see there's a difference. Notebook is lightweight. So a notebook can, you can think of it like you can use it for small, for basic functionalities. Like let's say browsing the internet, doing your word processing, which you're going to learn about. So that is what it can do. Then desktop, we have already looked at desktop. It's an independent personal computer that is made especially for use on the desk, an office or a home. What we just do when we are looking at the physical, that is why we usually use it mostly for the physical appearance, like to use the desktop. So that, because it is something that we encounter and it is big enough to show the different parts of our computer. That is why we usually use. So you have the laptop. I think you can look at that. It is battery operated. It has that. You can see. Then you have the palm top. We are talking about palm tops. Before when smartphone came, we had the palm top. But even our smartphones are a form of a palm top because it can fit. It's called palm top because it can fit within our palms. When you look at our palms, you can look at. And you can confirm that, you can see that. So software and hardware, a computer has two main components. Hardware are the physical components, the ones that you can touch and feel, and know that these, you can say that this is what, and you can be able to see, usually see they are tangible. That is really tangible. So hardware is tangible, that is hardware. Usually just put it in short form as that, and software. Software usually say, software, we say it is intangible, meaning we cannot see and we cannot touch them. So apart from abacus, what other computers were there before the first generation? I think I showed you, but you can just check. But abacus is the most prominent. I'm talking about all those, anything that we're able to use to do the simple calculations was deemed as a computer. That is where computers started. So, yes. Shown in the diagram, I think I already shown you the diagram. So software, let's look at when you get out of the video. When I look at software, I'm going to show you a very small description of which, as we also think of concluding the class, basic hardware units, I've already shown this. So I talked about all this. The input is the scanner, the video capture card, the microphones, all of these are there with you. But you can check. I think I gave you as an assignment. So, but I'm not expecting you to just copy and paste whatever is here. I'd like to see more. So let me get out of there. Let me get out of there. Computer software, but I'm not going to, you're going to look at the notes at one point in time. I'm not going to use those notes to explain that. I'm not going to use the notes, but you're free to look at them at that point in time. But we are going to look at software in this case. You can see, I usually like to stop to look at it differently. So I'll not go through all this. You're going to look at it at your own point in time, then I'm going to look at the questions. So let me not cover this. This is for my own time. So let me go to my email. So let me stop sharing it. Download something. Let me download something from my email. So any questions so far? Any questions? Any questions so far on what we've covered? Any questions? Any questions? Can be clear. Okay, it's loading. The assignment done. The assignment must be done. The assignment, even if I've not revised anything, I think I've even just covered and just given you some guide. I've not gotten you an answer about your question. Definitely, you unmute yourself and laugh. I'm not getting you. I'm just loading a certain PowerPoint, then we look at it. So it's loading. What are the disadvantages of advantages included in the modern technology? So there are the ones that are written down there, but most of the disadvantages that are there within a computer, the disadvantages that are there are usually health related, because you can't, if you stay on the computer for too long, it can affect your eyes. If you can cause maybe back problems, if you don't place your wrist well when you're typing, you can get wrist problems, back problems, neck problems. Most of the time, those are the disadvantages that come with computing. Others can also see computer as a disadvantage when it replaces them, because there's what you call job replacement or job displacement. That is why we are teaching you, even if you're doing a Bachelor of Education Arts or Bachelor of Education Science, or you're doing Actuarial Science, or you're doing any course that you're doing, that is why we are actually teaching you computer applications, because we don't want you to go to a school somewhere, then they tell you, you want our marks typed and printed, or using Excel or using Word, you type a report, then you're wondering what is Word, you're hearing it for the first time. Then you're saying you went to campus or you went to university, you don't want that. So a computer has come to become a utility that you can't do without. So that is why it is even a common unit. My computer, you know, right now, if you're talking about my computer, I have my laptop here. We have the smart board there. So the smart board is not a screen, it is a computer in itself. So there's somebody has started screen sharing. Donina, if you don't stop that sharing, I'm going to remove you from the class. Okay. Okay. What is the security? Why is it allowing people to share? You don't share your screen. You do that, I remove you from the class. Okay. Lydia kindly asked me assignment related questions at the end of the class. At the end of the class. Yeah, you can submit. Just give me your details and I'll help you resubmit. That. What is the difference between register and ALU? Mungawa Sike. So we just log in here first. Recording. Disadvantage, I don't know. Okay, no one is a disadvantage because I was expecting the assignment to be submitted before this class. So anybody submitting after this class is basically submitting a late assignment submission. So obviously I'll penalize them for late submission. So I think I gave you a whole 1 week to do the assignment and to look, and you're not disadvantaged. That is the reason I've discussed the assignment, so that you know I was expecting. And then I believe this is something that you were actually researching on the internet. And I was expecting you what to research on the internet is basically because you're not getting it from your head, unless you invented the computers. So I'm expecting you to look at that. So for those who are saying they have been unable to submit, you look at to some of us. Okay. What's your yakai waiting room, kidogo? Afikirieshi deko wapi. Aye, so Zoom. Screen. So are you seeing this? Are you seeing the slide?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, Esther, you plan to submit at night. Don't worry, don't worry. You're going to just submit the assignment. I'm looking at it. So I'm back. Sorry about that. So you can see the objective is that you should be able to know about computer software and the classification that there is. You should be able to understand what is system software and the different software that there is in that category and the application and the importance of computing. The other thing you should be able to understand is to explain the application of the software and the different, explain a special software and the different software in that category, such as general purpose, special purpose software. Explain ready-made versus tailor-made software. So going on, I'll move very fast with this. So software, you can see it can be abbreviated in two ways, is SW and S-W. Basically, it is a set of programs. Or hardware that perform a specific task. All the programs that run in a computer are what we call software, and there are three types. So software cannot run without hardware. So, and hardware is useless without software. So that is why we want that. So going on, you can see there are different types, but the main ones is usually the system software and the application software. Those are the two main categories that are there. And what is very important is to know it is a set of instructions. So software is just a set of instructions that tell the computer what to do and when to do it. You can see a program must tell the computer each set of tasks to perform in a certain kind of a logic, so that the computer knows exactly what to do and when to do it. And another thing that is very important when you're talking about software, there are two main things. Data, and the other thing is also information on the other side. So you can see those are the two main terminologies that come in play. So going on, a program, I can see data are what you call raw facts and ideas. So let me just remove this so that you can see. A program must tell the computer each set of tasks to perform data are raw facts and ideas that have not been processed, when information is data that has been processed so as to be useful to the user. Very important to note, processed data. So we thrive on information. We thrive on information. For example, if I give you this, what is that? Is it data or is it information? Somebody tell me, is it data or is it information? You can unmute.
Data.
Data.
It's called data. Why do you think it's data?
Data, Mwalimu.
Why do you call it data? Why do you say it's data? Somebody say the reason. Don't just say that and leave it that. Why do you call it data?
Because it's not processed.
It is not processed.
That is not an answer. That is not an answer.
Okay.
It's data, of course. All that has been presented, whoever has been presented to does not know what does it mean.
Exactly, exactly. You don't know what it means. So, I'd like us to always avoid this scenario where you think data is information that has not been processed. Information is data that has not been processed. That is the worst curse you can put to yourself if you think of it as that. Was just say data are raw facts, information is processed data. It is never as simple as that. Just need to think of it as Judas said. Can you make sense of it? If you cannot make sense of it, it is not information, it is data. So let me have some conversion to it. So so do you see that can now make sense, right? That 5896, yes. It can be a pin, somebody's pin, even to access, maybe let's say M-Pesa. It can be the number of megabytes, let's say a flash disk has space of, or maybe what, a computer. It can be the number of boys in a boys' high school or girls. So think of it that way. Maybe we can also add that so that you don't look like I'm biased. So you can see once you have that data, it needs to be given into some information. But still, this one is not fully processed into information. It is still not yet processed into information. Who can tell me why it is not information yet? Who can tell me why is it not yet information? Even though you can still make sense of it, maybe how it looks, but it is not yet information. Why? Why is it not yet information? Why is it not yet information? Somebody to tell us. 5896. You know this one was exactly, you know this one is now data. You know this one has some sense now. It makes sense of it.
So,
but why is it? Yes, yes, Brenda.
As for me, it's still data because it's just like you've entered it in the computer. You've just written it.
Okay, that is, you're almost close. You're almost close to that. So someone to mute themselves because I'm getting some feedback from my end. Okay, sorry. I think I've asked somebody to unmute instead of them not. Okay, so don't unmute. As I've said, one thing that is important to realize, one thing that is very important to realize is this part. Have you seen that part? It must be useful to the user, right? You can see that. So this one, it cannot be useful to you unless you know it is whose M-Pesa pin. You don't know whether it is Kevin's, Jude's, Brenda's, Musau's, or whoever is here. Maybe there's somebody who is looking at that and says, hey, Kevin knows my M-Pesa pin. If only he knew that it is my number, that is when it can be useful to him, because that is when, and also it can only be useful to me if I know it is your number and I know ways of how I can access, right? So I hope you understand that. Then 5896 megabytes. I don't know whether it is space in the cloud, space in the flash disk, space, or if it's not space, it is the data that that has taken some certain kind of space. If it is 5896, is it 5,896 boys of which high school, which girls' school? You can see, and it is data collected for which? Is it from ones, from twos? Is it the whole school and all that? So you can see, we need to continue getting it into that. And it is the work of the computer to now help you convert data into information. If you remember the definition of a computer. Let's move on. I'll not cover much on this today because it's quite wide. So you can see these are the main categories of a computer. Software, classification of a computer, computer software. So when we're talking about computer software, we're talking about basically finishing it up as this. There's the system software, there's application software. Then within it, let me not start here. Let me just do something fast. Then let me check what is there next. System software. Application software. That is nice. So we're going to cover that sometime. So let me go to something here. Just want to show you this, then we close the class. I'm going to do a new one. It's mine. Okay, so let me do something here. don't know, it's a coincidence that it has been like part of what? So, what usually have when we talk about softwares and hardware and their relationship is that here, usually have the hardware. Then we have the system software. Then we have the application. That is basically how they relate to one another. Without the hardware, there's nowhere the system software can ride on. The system software is now what has the direct connection with the hardware. The application software is controlled by the system software. Without the system software, you cannot install any application software. That is why for your phone, you must have an Android operating system before you can install Zoom, before you can install the Taraka e-learning app, before you can install WhatsApp, you must have the system software in place. So here you're talking about the hardware, you already know them. So when you're talking about system software, here you're talking about the Android.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Is it hardware or software?
What exactly?
Before a system software, is it hardware or software?
It is hardware. Because all these are software. This one are software. So we can put software here. Basically what we mean here is that I'm trying to show you the relationship between hardware and software, right? How do they relate with one another, right? So hardware is the basic foundation. You need the hardware. You need the hardware for anything. Before you get the software, you need the hardware, right?
Right.
Yeah, so that is it. So yeah, if you talk about the Android, you can think, somebody can tell me the system software. You can just be telling me if you know them. Which are the other system software that are there? Which are the other system software for those who are right ahead? Or maybe you already know. What are the other system software? Yes? You don't know any other system software? There are so many. The ones for computers, which ones are they? Yes?
Windows 7.
Yes, to all the Windows flavors. So we have Windows. Here we can talk about Windows 7, 8, 8.1, Windows 10, Windows XP, Windows Vista, all of those that Windows that you know. The latest one I think is 10. So Windows is the other one, which is the other kind of
Apple's Mac OS.
Yes. Yes, you have the Apple's. So this one is by Microsoft, so it's called Microsoft Windows. It is owned by Microsoft, so there's Apple's Mac operating system. Yes, there are so many, it's called Linux. There are so many flavors of Mac, but just say Mac OS. There's one also very, very important system software. Yes, I can see
Chrome,
some of you.
Chrome or
OS. Okay, there's Chrome OS. There's Chrome OS. I think that is also owned by Google. It's the Google.
Mozilla Firefox.
And there's also one. Yes?
Mozilla, yes? Firefox.
Firefox is not a software. Firefox is not a system software, I mean. It is an application software, which is a part of a browser, but it is not a system software. Is someone who's writing, Sereti Samuel was writing it, is Linux operating system. Here now we have Ubuntu, we have the Debian, we have the CentOS, Linux, Mint. There are so many flavors. They are mostly used in servers. So those ones are the ones. Yeah. So those are them. Those are the system software. So for application software, basically we have them as this. Application software. We need to categorize them. I'm not going to so much detail. There's productivity software, there's productivity, there's entertainment. Okay. Before I go to productivity and entertainment, there's a bigger category. There's ready-made software. Then there's also tailor-made application software. So they are there. So then within them, all of these, that other, what I've just told you, is the productivity. Then there's the entertainment kind of software. There's office, I think office automation, which is also part of productivity. There are so many there. We're going to check on that. So since I know maybe next week is all about you planning to report on campus and all that, I'm not going to give you an assignment this week. So I'm not going to give you an assignment this week so that you have time to prepare. But once you report next week, tunarudi kwa yomponde kwa assignments. But don't forget that I've told you to look at the classifications of software, and that is classification of computers according to functionality and purpose. So just look at that. I'm not going to ask you to submit it, but in the next class, I think which the next class might be the other week, that is, I don't know, when is it? Somebody can confirm for me. That is the other Wednesday after this Wednesday. But once we report on campus, you're going to be having now two sessions. You're going to have a theory session. You're also going to be having a practical session. And you're going to have a schedule where you go to the lab, the computer lab, and do some practicals. Some practical sessions. Somebody is asking about which sessions. I don't know whether I can pardon anything. The good thing is I'm recording, so you can rewind the recording later and hear what I say. But I don't know what like about to pardon. So this is it. I'm not going to go further from this because time is almost up. Actually, it is already up. Let's all note Let me stop the recording for the class session because the class is over.